2 of travel here, and I still haven't even left the continental United States. Did get a good sleep last night in the hotel here. Same clothes as yesterday because all my bags, I really hope, still at the airport, still checked in and waiting to go to London. The shuttle bus leaves in 10 minutes to the airport, so it'd be good if I was on that. We're thinking positive thoughts for today. I do want to get to Bergen. I guess one cool thing about this morning is that I don't have any bags to carry. I am already checked in. And I have TSA pre, so I can pretty much waltz straight through security, which is going to be awesome. So I woke up to find the rebook of my flight from London to Copenhagen. Apparently needed 24 hours to either confirm or not, and they chose the or not option. So having thought I booked a flight last night to have me covered when I go to Heathrow, I had not. Rebooked it today, I do have a confirmation, and I downloaded the SAS app and checked in. So on paper, I should be good. But who uses paper anymore? I'm out of here.
Mic,
yeah,
and you're doing video,
yeah,
and this is your tripod.
Yeah.
You get good resolution.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's very compact and very simple. So you're just documenting your travel,
exactly
wherever they want me. Good.
All right, first flight of the day, Newark to Chicago. Looking for no more delays.
Hi.
Hi.
Welcome.
Ooh,
tripod?
Yeah, that's a tripod right there.
Cool.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to Chicago. C11. Apparently they just opened the new United Polaris Lounge in Terminal C. So I'm kind of excited about that. Wish I had a couple hours to enjoy all the features because I think it's going to be pretty incredible. But I will also be very happy if my flight takes off on time and we get out ahead of the snow. There's a massive storm coming to Chicago right now. Storm is supposed to be here at 6. My flight is at 4:15. In about an hour and 40 minutes. And I really hope I get out of here on time. This is Chicago. Always take the stairs. That's about as much exercise as I'm going to get today.
Are you traveling first class or business international?
Business international to London.
Okay, welcome. Okay,
thanks. Hi.
How are you?
Good. If the snow stays away, I'm going to be even better.
I think it's trying to stay for a little while.
What time do they think it's going to hit?
6:30 or
6:30?
Yeah. Thank you. Welcome.
So the London flight might be okay?
I think you might be okay.
Awesome. Thank you. Okay, the new Polaris Lounge in Chicago O'Hare gets a big thumbs up. Super nice little private workspaces, plenty of power outlets, a lot of nice food. It's a really quick turnaround for me here, only about 30 minutes in the lounge, but I'm so happy to potentially, stay tuned, because this is still only potentially, be getting out on time to London. And when I say on time, I mean at least a day late. And still only potentially making my connection to Norway. to the point where I have seriously been considering getting a private flight to Bergen from London. And I kind of set a number in my head, like, okay, I don't want to let anyone down on this gig. I've never missed a show in my entire career. How do I keep that streak alive? How do I not let all the people down that are coming to it? How do we make this concert happen, record it, film it, do all the things we set out to do with this project? How do we make that happen? So I'm seriously considering getting a private jet, a charter plane of some sort. I mean, this might be a hot air balloon at this point. Kind of have a crazy figure in my head, a limit that I've set myself financially speaking that I will go to make this happen. And it is not cheap. So far, there's nothing under about $12,000. And we're only talking about a flight that's about an hour and 45 minutes long. What I need to do is find six or seven other people that are going from London to Bergen, and then it would make it very cost effective. Quite how I do that from the lounge in Chicago when I'm gonna be on a flight all night is beyond me, but maybe Twitter and Instagram and Facebook and YouTube will help out in that regard. And I'll put out a big plea for people to come forward that maybe want to go randomly from London Heathrow or the surrounding area to Bergen, Norway. And then I suppose I'll offer free tickets to the show as well if we can squeeze a few more people in. The show's already sold out. That's kind of why I really want to get there and make it and not miss a show. So the journey continues. Got 10 minutes more work I can do here. And I'm going to the gate. We are getting on the plane in 25 minutes. Quick side note, in between all the travel debacles, it's probably the lightest I've ever traveled right now. This one backpack. And it is one of the most freeing experiences in 20 years of being on the road. It is a really awesome thing to have basically stripped down everything I carry down to this one bag. And there's a lot of stuff in there. Maybe that's another vlog, like what goes in my carry-on. Because there's a ton of stuff in there. I can get a lot done while I'm out here on the road. Wow, they're boarding already. They know the snow's coming. They are hustling people on this plane super early, boarding 20 minutes earlier than they had advertised. Take two. Here we go. Getting on the plane. Let's hope this Polaris business class is actually installed and not just advertised.
Can we see the sign?
Back pillow, head pillow, first blanket, second blanket, headphones. Okay, again, we've got enough bedding for a small army. It's gonna be comfortable if nothing else. Facing backwards, not sure how I feel about that. I normally get a seat facing forwards, but I get a good view of the, wow, it just started snowing. Oh my God. Doubt the camera is gonna pick that up, but there is just the first few flakes of snow starting to fall. That is why they're hustling us on the plane. 22 degrees outside or something, maybe even colder, it's insane. So we're gonna be de-iced. I'm gonna have a nice view of one of the engines all the way to London. First thing I do is get on and check out the movies, try and plan out how much I'm gonna work, how many movies I'm gonna watch. That's be a shorter flight than I'm used to, because I'm used to flying from LA to London more often, which is like a solid 10 and a half hours, 11 hours, something like that. So I can normally work for a couple of hours, watch two movies, and still get like a solid 6 hours sleep. So this is gonna be, it's a new one for me in terms of flight time management, right? This snow is official.
And we're moving.
We are moving, just as I was giving up hope. Bad idea to be pessimistic. United Airlines making it completely impossible right now to stick to my no sugar situation.